There's a variety of base products just to make you feel confused and a little bit panicky. Well, just stick around because in this video I'm gonna clear all that up for you. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video sponsored by Light Elegance, we're gonna talk about the base products. We have 5 different base products to choose from. I'm gonna tell you all about them, when to use which one, and so on. So let's just jump right into it. First off, we have this little guy called Vada Prime. It is an acid-based vitamin E infused primer. And don't be put off by the fact that it is acid-based. It's not dangerous. You take the brush and you dab the excess off, and then you just take the tiniest little amount and you put it at the back third of the nail. Don't put it too close to the cuticle area because it will spread. So it will cover that back part and it will roughen up the surface. So if you have any type of lifting problems, this might be a solution for you, and especially, you know, if you have the lifting problems at the back of the nail. You can use the Vita Prime as it is to cover the entire nail and then put down your gel on top of that. Vita Prime is a little bit different from other primers that you've seen. Some primers, you know, they leave a chalky type of finish. Vita Prime does not leave this chalky finish. It just goes dry. So you want to make sure that it's completely evaporated before applying any type of product on top of that. If it's still wet, it could cause lifting. So you just go through all 10 fingers, let it air dry, and once you come back to that first finger, you're ready to put your next product on top of that. So just don't rush it. The next product that we're gonna talk about is Tack, formerly known as Bonder. Same product, just a different name, that's all. So Tack is a liquid type of bonder. It works like a double-sided sticky tape. One side sticks to the nail and the other side sticks to the gel. The cool thing with Tack is that it actually contains acetone. So this is perfect if you wanna use it on top of plastic tips because it's gonna seep into the plastic and create a really strong bonding, or you can actually put it on top of your acrylic. So if you have a acrylic extension and then you want to put down your gel on top of that, you take the tack, you put a thin layer over the entire nail, and then you cure it, and then it's going to create that perfect bonding for the next product to go on top of. This is actually my favorite combination. I use this for pretty much all my clients. I start with Vita Prime and then I apply tack. You don't have to double prime it or double bond. I do because my clients need to go for a long time in between fills, so that's why I do it. The next product we're gonna talk about is the Power Bond, and we have that in clear and we have it in pink. Power Bond is more of a gel consistency. You don't wanna put that on top of a plastic tip. You only put that on top of the natural nail, because if you put it on top of the plastic tip, you're gonna get separation. So the difference between these two, besides, you know, that this one is more liquid and these are more like gel, is that you use tack for brittle and thin nails up to normal nails. You use Power Bond for normal nails up to what we call hoof nails. You know, those really, really thick nails, and you file and file and nothing ever seems to happen. It's like toenails. You know, those really, really thick nails? That's when you use Power Bond. You can, of course, use tack for thicker nails. You can use Power Bond for thinner nails. But if you have problems, then you know that tack is more for thinner nails and normal nails, and Power Bond is more for thicker nails and normal nails. Last product that we have is called Air Bond. And as you can tell, this is a product that doesn't have to be cured in the light. It cures in the air. So if you are working, for example, only with our acrylic system and you don't have a UV or LED light, you can use this. So you just apply it over the entire nail and then put down your acrylic. Another thing that this is perfect for is actually those type of clients that are a bit sweaty. You know, they have really sweaty like nail beds and hands. The air bond will actually bond together with the water. So if you have a client like that, I would start with air bond and then maybe tack or power bond after that. Hopefully that shed some light on your bonding confusion. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also check out Light Elegance YouTube channel for more tips, tricks, and product presentations. I will see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.